serving actor in Emmerdale, played Alan Turner. Manager at the home farm, more recently, of course, landlord of the Woolpack. He died sadly last night. We'll talk about that in just a bit. Now, taxi driver. This is a great story. A taxi driver from East Hull is hoping to win a visit to Mars as part of a new reality TV show. Now, the Mars One project was thought up by one of the creators of Big Brother. The show are looking for four people, to go on a seven-month journey of a lifetime. Melissa Ead has got through the selection process, beating 40,000 others. Now, if successful and chosen to land on the red planet, she'll first have to complete 7 years of training before liftoff. And it is a one-way ticket. I spoke to her and asked her what attracted her about a potential trip to the red planet.
The Mars One project is being set up as... it's like funding to get four people to Mars. Now, everybody's saying it's impossible to go to Mars.
Yeah.
It's not impossible, Peter. It can be done, but it's going to take a lot of money, a lot of know-how, a lot of time.
Why are you fascinated by this?
I'm fascinated by any big challenge, Peter.
Oh, yeah.
I came across it and I knew I had to go for it.
So, if you get to be the winner, you get to travel to Mars. Isn't being a taxi driver enough travelling for you?
No, not at all. And personally, a lot of people will be out there saying, what has a taxi driver got to do with being an astronaut?
Well, it occurred to me earlier this morning, I thought, she's a taxi driver in Hull. What will she know about being an astronaut?
Exactly. And my answer to that is,
yeah,
the actual Mars One project is choosing people from all different backgrounds and everything. And I think my job as a taxi driver, it's built my character to accept everybody, regardless of age, gender, sexuality, nationality.
Right.
And made me realise no people are the same, no two people.
Well, that's true.
In situations, I've had very strenuous and challenging situations which it forced me to stop and think about what to do next in order to get the best outcome.
How many miles is it to Mars? Do you know?
Offhand, no. And I think that actually, it goes on the positioning of Earth and Mars at the time. I'll be honest with you, Peter, I don't know a lot about space.
Right.
It isn't something I woke up as a child and thought, I want to be an astronaut.
Right.
I saw the challenge, I saw the concept, I liked everything about it, and me being me, I had to go for it.
You've done very well, though, haven't you? Because you are one of less than 400 people who are shortlisted to be chosen. Why do you think you've done so well?
To be honest, I'm not quite sure those figures are correct. Now, from what I can gather, there's 80,000 people applied to the project now.
80,000? 80,000 people want to go to Mars?
That's right, yeah. It's a one-way trip, by the way. Did you know that? There's no coming back. But yeah, there's 80,000...
Hang on. So you get to go, and then do you actually die on Mars?
You will do, yeah. What they're trying to do is colonise Mars. They're setting up a colony, but the actual gravity and everything on Mars changes your own body makeup.
Right.
And you would never be able to return to Earth because it changes mass.
Why on Earth would you want to do this?
Why not? It's a challenge, Peter.
Where do you live now?
In Hull.
Yeah, whereabouts? Which area?
Holderness Road.
Yeah, you've got shops, you've got restaurants, you're just close into town. You got there, to Mars, you've got to start a colony. Where do you get your food from? There's no shops on Mars, you know. There's no Tesco Express.
No, I know that. But 7 years of training for the final 40, you get through to the final 40.
Right.
There's 7 years intensive training, and one of those will be in farming, how to grow your own food and everything. So we'll be growing our own food up there as well.
Right.
There's a lot of other things.
Oh, and once you're there and you're growing your own food and living on Mars, how long can you live on Mars before it kills you?
Nobody actually knows the answer to that because, again, it's never been done. It's a first. So we're guinea pigs, and the world will find out. And it's, again, it's one of the challenges we're taking. We don't know what we're going for,
well,
and only find out when we get there.
Melissa, 80,000 people, you're on the short list. I mean, it is amazing. If you really were to get a call today to say you can go this afternoon, would you really do it?
I would, Peter, yes, without a doubt. I would not back out. It's something I've set my mind on, and when I set my mind on something, I go for it, and there is no back out. It's
what about,
a challenge.
What about your friends and your family and everything that you're going to leave behind? Because you're not going to see them, you can't ring them. I mean, you're just saying goodbye to everybody.
But making new friends.
Well, you don't know. You might not. Be stuck on Mars with another 39 people that you don't like, all dying together. I mean, where's the attraction in that?
It's groundbreaking, Peter. It's something I have to explain.
Well, no, it's groundbreaking, but I can't see the plus point. I just can't see the plus point.
It helps mankind. That's the plus point, and somebody's got to do it.
Right.
And if somebody's got to do it, why not me?
Well, absolutely, Melissa. Now, listen, I mean, you do enough miles driving around as the taxi driver in Hull. You're going to miss that, aren't you?
I'm going to miss a lot of things, but again, without anything, there's no progress, Peter.
You're not going to be here to see the progress because you're going to pass out and die on Mars.
But I know I've done it.
Bet it.
I sound like a crazy woman, don't I?
You do sound like a crazy woman. I admire you for what you're doing, but I just don't quite get it, really. I just don't quite get it. I really don't.
But people, when they said they was going to fly to the moon and these astronauts but they didn't know they was coming back, Peter. They did not know. When they set foot into that space rocket, there was no guarantees that they was coming back. And they was just going there because it was the challenge of it.
But you know that you're not coming back. You're going all the way to Mars. You're going to set up and live there, and then you're going to die.
I'm not saying how old I am, but I'm getting on in life anyway, so a lot of my life is over, so why not give the rest to mankind?
Okay. Well, I'm too polite to ask you your age, but I don't think it matters.
It's actually on the website if you want to look.
No. What have your friends said about this?
Probably all think I'm crazy, of course, for the friends, so they're going to stand by me with what I do, like any good friend would do. There's a lot of scepticism and the rest of it about it, but they're there for me, and I'm sure they'll be set to wave me off.
Well, listen, very good to have you on the programme, Melissa. Thank you very much indeed for coming on. You might be the only person I've ever interviewed in my career that ends up on Mars.
Who knows, Peter? Fingers crossed. And the more people that get to know about me, if they can go to my application and give me a 5-star vote, that might just help get me there.
Right. You realise that there's no point in taking your mobile, don't you?
I can't go on Twitter or anything.
No, you won't be able to ring me one morning and say I'm just cooking some eggs and bacon here on the red planet with a cup of coffee, Peter.
But Peter, I don't know if you've actually read into it. The people who are on Mars are going to have a link up with Earth. I know it takes a lot of time for the distance for it to travel, but the world is going to have the opportunity to watch us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. So, yeah, I can. I'll wave to you, Peter, and I'll say, hi, Peter, remember when we spoke?
I look
there, there you go, there's a promise.
There's a promise. I've got a promise from Melissa. She's going to wave at me from Mars. Listen, I wish you well. You've done extremely well so far. 80,000 people applied for this. You're down to the last 40. Fantastic.
And Peter, can I just put that right? I am not down to...
There's
80,000 applied.
Yeah.
There's 500 and odd of those people from the website for voting.
Yeah.
Nobody actually knows how it's going.
But
I am on the website.
To get 500 from 80,000 is fantastic. I mean, it's fantastic. Listen, I wish you well, Melissa. Thank you very much indeed.
My pleasure, Peter.
Take care. Safe journey. Bye.
I took the perfect avenue down the road to both of you.